Compulsion to speak up actually after years of silence when women were actually keeping it, holding it back inside themselves, and they wanted to actually come out and expressing their views and vision. So there came a time when she said that I'm not going to really hold back, I'm going to speak up. And that's why this whole idea, She Speaks, came up. It's also about this whole journey that a woman has taken up, has traveled, has walked towards freedom, towards liberation, towards finding her own identity and walking on that. So this is an idea which is bold. This comes out of a very strong belief of a woman. This comes out of a realization that what she chooses is her own choice. And today, if you talk about women empowerment, women choices are very, very important. So choices, I would say, is something that a woman makes, and that's why she now is ready to speak up, and that's why she's yours. Chota sa bol diya, I think, through.
So She Speaks as a... Speaks is an initiative by Amra Foundation. Every woman deserves her voice, not only to be heard, but only to be felt and meant as well. What we're trying to She Speaks is that whatever the women are deserving, whatever that they have belonged in their life, that's what they really want to achieve, to give that voice to that woman so that she goes ahead and makes that impression in the world. That's the work we're trying to do. She Speaks.
I think it's a great opportunity for all of us who have gathered here, women from all walks of life, who want to hear the achievers and all the women who've made it despite all odds. And I believe that She Speaks is a program that will inspire upcoming leaders from every field, be it the arts or the literature or politics or social leadership. It's a huge opportunity for women, girls, gentlemen from all walks of life, and I wish She Speaks all success, and I hope that it goes on to invite not only women who have been successful in achieving whatever they wanted to, but also in inviting women who have done something radically different in their lives, who have charted a different course, and who are willing to take risks to achieve what they want. Thank you so much.
She Speaks transforms that energy into a bigger energy that is meant to take it forward and give that voice a meaning. Come, let's together make this voice and give that a value.
Amra Foundation is an organization which is doing a number of things, which includes promotion of arts, promotion of arts, culture, cinema, and empowerment of women. Today's event is basically we are getting a group of eminent women who are going to speak about empowerment of women, their problems, issues which concern them, and there will be a case study on the basis of which each of them will react on various women-centric issues.
This program is
Padmashree Shobhna Narayan ji, Padmashree Malini Awasthi ji, I just got a message from her that her son has fallen and she has rushed to hospital with her son. So she is not here at the moment. Senior editor, HT, Poonam Saxena ji, OHS author, Joint Secretary UPSC, Neelam Saxena Chandra ji, our special invitees for the evening, Ms. Suzanne Joseph, Acting High Commissioner, New Zealand, Mr. Raj Chingappa, Editor, India Today, Ms. Namrata Kumar, Deputy DG ICCR, and a very augustus audience. I know each one of you is for the causes of growth. I extend a very warm welcome to you all in edition 2 of Amara She Speaks on behalf of Amara Foundation. Today is indeed a very memorable day in the brief journey of Amara Foundation. We have with us on dais an extremely reputed panel, each named a stalwart in its profession, not requiring any introductions. The Amara Foundation has been extremely fortunate that even though we are a nascent organization, we have always received support from the best minds in the country, be it chalking out a policy, a program, a workshop, a fair, or a festival. And this inspires us further to do a lot of good work. Amara Foundation came into formal existence in the year 2012, month of April. Since then, the foundation has constantly strived fulfilling the overall objectives and the mission goal to make this planet a more beautiful place to live with a laser-sharp focus. Since then, we have constantly reinvented, reformed, and improvised ourselves. During the year 2012 and 2013, the foundation was continuously engaged in providing skilling workshops in costume jewelry making in many NGOs and urban slums, completely free of cost, with the overall objectives of making women gainfully employed. During the year 2015, when we felt that our skill development programs were somewhat plateauing due to personal reasons largely, as I got more involved with my soon-to-be-released work of fiction. The focus somehow automatically shifted more sharply towards the cultural scenario in alignment with the overall objectives of Amara Foundation. And we presented before the people of Delhi a very unique festival, Amrotsar, synergizing all the components of culture. I shall make very important announcements today regarding the team expansion in all three of our projects. Aroman, which is our skill development project, Amrotsar, which is our annual cultural festival, and She Speaks, which we try to do triannually. Now, coming back to She Speaks, what is She Speaks? What is the vision behind She Speaks? idea behind She Speaks is a very simple one. Across centuries, women's voice has remained stifled in the four walls of the house. Sometimes in the name of shame, and sometimes in the name of family honor. She grows up learning that there is glory in silence, sacrifice, and submission. The gender bias has been internalized by women so deeply, and it is so ingrained in their subconscious that many times they even fail to take notice of its manifestation. It's deep, multi-layered, and nuanced. It finds multiple reflections across continents and cultures, in every society and in every part of the world. Half the population goes through this every minute. She Speaks is an endeavor to give women a voice. The format of the seminar ensures that the voice is heard through a broad spectrum of society. Efforts are made to bring successful women on a common platform with not so fortunate ones. We encourage and facilitate a dialogue between the panelists, participants, and the audiences. Panelists are drawn from the government, media, art and culture, politics, corporate, banking, writers, authors, journalists, and thinkers. An attempt is made to present a unique case study every time. The solutions to the problem are deliberated and discussed, and also the road ahead for redressal and eradication of the problem. Welcome, Sonal Gandhiji. We plan to map and document the findings to be able to present a white paper to the Ministry of Women and Child Development at the end of 3 years of the project, that is by March 2019. At the cost of sounding repetitive, I once again want to say how extremely privileged and honored I feel introducing such a hugely loved and respected panel by media and public, none requiring an introduction, but the protocols must be followed. A very special panel today, epitomizing creativity and culture, and also extremely supportive of the causes very close to my heart and the Amara Foundation. A bias-free, egalitarian society and the world. Please give them a big round of applause. Padma Vibhushan Sonal Mansingh-ji is an eminent Indian classical dancer and a leading exponent of Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, and Chau. A renowned, decorated, and awarded personality, choreographer, teacher, orator, mentor, and a social activist. I call upon stage Secretary, Ministry of External Affairs, Sri involved and aware of people and their problems. She is a regular and most ardent champion of issues related to women's problems and the specially abled. I call upon Shri Vijay Bakshi. Shobhna ji knows it. Siti is not being able to come. Her son just fell down and she has rushed into the hospital. Poonam Saxena Chandraji is a household name and has been associated with Hindustan Times for a very long time. She is the former editor of Brunch and now the Sunday and now the National Weekend Editor at HD. I invite Sri Amrendra Khatwa. Joint Secretary UPSC and has authored several books, a Limca Award holder for maximum published works in a single year. She has written fiction in English and Hindi. In 2014, she was awarded the Rabindranath Tagore International Award in addition to many other awards. I invite Sri K.L. Malhotra to come and honor her. I'm not prepared, which I always fumble, my tongue fumbles always. It fumbles on many words. And Rashmi Singh, our dear friend, is not here. She is inaugurating an industry in the interiors of Andaman, and she told me that I should keep in touch via phone, and she would like to give a message on phone when we discuss case study. Gender and culture, is there a connection? I would like to throw this question to our panelists and audiences both. Do you think that there is a connect between culture and gender?
Yes.
Yes? Yes. Yes. So ever since the civilization evolved on planet Earth, on Mother Earth, a strange thing happened. The half the population gained privileges and half the population did not. Could it be a byproduct of culture? Could it be a byproduct of civilization? Because this is something which is not simply confined to Indian subcontinent or South Asia, but across the globe. So I would like to invite my expert panelists to seek their view because they all come from the field of creativity. So let's have their opinion, and I would like to invite Dr. Saran to moderate this segment with me. Dr. Saran. I would like to invite Padmashree, Padma Bhushan, Sonal Mansingh-ji for her opinion on what she thinks, could there be a connection between gender and culture, and over to Dr. Saran.
Alright, there's less gentlemen for a change, so welcome to this evening. It's been an honor to stand out here, and you don't know how much effort that we had to put her to get her up here to speak. But so that we're doing it together, and before we invite ma'am out here for her views. This question is for gentlemen to begin with. How many gentlemen have ever thought that their life is happening by magic? How many gentlemen have here thought that their life is happening by magic? That means at 6 o'clock, the tea comes to you magically. At 6:30, you go to the washroom, you get your stuff in there. If you don't, then you yell out again that where is it? At 7:15, the breakfast appears by magic. If you have to go to office, things happen. If you are still missing something, who do you call up? And then your kids go to school by magic. They study by magic. They come and give you the report where you say, so what happened in school today? And the answer comes like, nothing much. Okay, then talk to your mom. And then in the evening, again, the food comes to you by magic. While you're watching television and conveniently, telling how bad office was and so on and so forth. Whereas she might also be working, by the way, right? And then in the evening, everything's said and done, you just complain that whole system is so unfair and bad, whereas heat language takes care of things. How many people really believe that stuff that's happening? Any guys out here? Gentlemen? Yes. They're one of the best on that one, yeah. But if you guys and I and you as gentlemen that we walked out of here today and we walked out to that special woman today and said thank you so much for being there in my life, that'd be a kind of a mission accomplished for us today, right?
That's a good thing.
Okay, this something you really make tonight special by doing that extra thing, extra mile every single day. So we're gonna invite ma'am on there, with her thoughts.
I was under the impression that as the chairperson of the panel, I would be the last.
Right.
So it's better than Henry.
Sure, absolutely. Since you are the chair, you get to decide that part as well.
We are all in chairs anyway.
Yeah, absolutely. And you make sure that you sit and you get those things. So men are at men are at disposal today, and men are at service as well today. So make the most of it. Tell us what the real power is, which I really believe in.
Disposal, not disposable.
Yeah, they're at disposal today, so we're going to make that happen today. So, Mr. Narayan, we're going to start with you, ma'am. If you could share with us about your thoughts, culture,
gender,
together.
Well, the word culture is rather large. The entire ambit covers almost anything and everything. And it's determined the geographical location and that we are born in, as well as and therefore a lifestyle which emerges. And in that lifestyle, yes, women everywhere in all cultures now, I'm using the word in the larger sense, in all cultures of the world have a specific role. And sometimes we do find, as she mentioned, that they've had to take a beating in some way or the other, and they were considered, and they had to fight for their rights. Now, if I look at it, yes, that has been there. It's become a patriarchal society largely, but let us even look into our own milieu. When I think of certain pockets in this country, which was actually a matriarchal society, and those pockets have today become rather patriarchal. So what is it? So where have we? Now we are also contributors to that whole system. That even a matriarchal society in certain pockets of our own country are now becoming largely patriarchal. So I think we need to question ourselves. Have we been able why haven't we been able to keep, we have in our own country, we have examples where women, when they have wanted to do something, they have done exceedingly well. Our literature is full of instances. I need not go into all those names, whether it is from ancient period or medieval period or today's period or yesterday's period or even in the periods to come. But the fact is that when women have wanted, they have. Nothing has stood in their way. They have made the impossible possible, and they have been great achievers. I would also say, when you're talking about culture and gender, that the way a cultural development takes place, both are equal. I mean, both are party to it. We, with our, if I'm, now we're talking about the gender part of it, if the women gender, even with their silence, they are party to it, because they are either accepting the wrongs and in fact their silence is promoting it, or if they are not silent about it, or they are very aggressively, this, whichever way, they are part of it. They're part of society. We have never been, some way or the other, the kind of a cultural milieu and a philosophical milieu that has a philosophy of a culture that emerges, we have all been participants in that particular game. And we continue to be participants, and we'll always be there, because society is always made up of the two. Today, it is lovely to see that this kind of, when there was darkness, if I see it from the woman's point of view, that there was a dark phase, the so-called dark phase. But at the same time, today we are seeing many women breaking out of the molds, going against the flow of tide, doing what they want with conviction. And since they're doing it with conviction, it's they are also succeeding. However, having said this, you said a general thing about gender. Let me also say that in this process of awareness, you have in the last 150 years ago, the male gender actually also triggering off this whole process of social revolution, which have benefited women. So both of them have been playing either the a positive role or a negative role. So both have been contributing equally to the creation of a mindset, which is part of a cultural milieu. And today we see that in pockets everywhere.
And Benjamin, according to a research done, are you aware that between the age 0 to 8, every child gets to hear one word maximum from their parents? Guess what? Absolutely. Beta, don't do it this way. No. This is not the way to do it. This is not the way to eat. This is not the way to speak. This is not the way to wear up. Here's the bad news though. You know, what is the ratio between boys and girls, and how many different, how many times more the girls or girl child has to hear no rather than her boy sibling or male sibling? Any idea? 100%, ma'am? You are very optimistic, actually. We found out that it is at 3 times. A girl child gets to hear 3 times more no's than her male sibling. And here is the bad news. Guess who she hears it from? Absolutely, yeah. So when ma'am was saying that, this is what happens many a times. So sometimes when we are passing on this message of yeses and no's, we don't really realize that how much negative reinforcement we start to give up rather than positive reinforcement. So we'll invite Ms. Kenna now to share her point of view, also that her points of culture versus gender.
Thank you. Actually, I think it'll be interesting if we kind of react to what we've all said and
yes,
so on.
Yes.
So I was listening to what Shobhna was saying, and I thought she said a lot of. There was a lot of truth, but I would just like to add to that. See, I think she was right when she said that all through the years, women have achieved something if they really wanted to. That's true. The problem is that if structurally the family or society, everything is weighed against women, then you need very exceptional women to achieve something. It's really weighed against your ordinary, average woman. Who can't, do that? If you have somebody who is very strong or very talented or very determined or very forceful or whatever, that person can do something and achieve something in a structure which is actually weighed against her. But it is so weighed in the disfavor of ordinary women that it doesn't really even count, you know. We've all heard stories of so-and-so's grandmother was so fantastic and, you know, she went and she did her MA and then she did her BA and she taught in a women's college and all that. But those were really the exceptions. The other thing is that you also said, which is also true, that, you know, women by their silence, also perpetuate a certain system. So I think what happens is when you have a certain structure that is so weighed against you, you just decide to co-opt into the system to survive and flourish. But what you actually have to do, and the only concessions you can get really, is if you fight. So I think women through the years have had to fight for things, fight for the right to vote in the Western countries, not in India, fight for the freedom to go and work, fight for the person they want to marry. There's so many fights, and these are battles you have to fight, otherwise no one is going to give these things to you. So you have to challenge the system, really. And I think a lot of times the women who we knew among families we know, or women in our family who ran beautiful homes and who entertained beautifully and looked after the men folks so well and served great meals, they were probably capable of doing much more, but they had to just channel their energies here, you know. This was the only outlet available to them, so they did a great job of that. But they were denied an opportunity, perhaps, to, you know. And I just want to actually say one little thing which struck me. I was recently reading a lot of Hindi short stories which are set in the 1940s and 50s and even earlier. I found a very interesting thread through all of them, which is that women at that time were not supposed to be educated. You know, ladki ko kya padhana, ghar ka kaam sikhao, khana pakana sikhao, vagaira, vagaira. So by and large, they were really just not educated at all. Whereas the men at least had to do a basic college education to get some kind of a job. So these men were married to these illiterate women, and they were so dissatisfied with their marriage, and they wanted an educated spouse, and they found they had nothing in common with these women. And that led to so much stress in the marriage even then, because they really wanted a partner. And but the social system was such that they could not get that kind of a partner. So it's not that men also didn't feel, but I think they had too much at stake in the status quo. So
I do add something to what Poonam has just said. You know, we were talking about how the societies have evolved, how the culture has come to be what it is today in favor of men and not so favor in women. I think it is also to do with at the beginning of the civilization, when we made homes, the roles which got assigned in the beginning were women, essentially, was the food gatherer, and the men were hunters. I think they brought home bread. And I think that very moment, in long, long time ago, the roles got defined, and we are carrying the baggage and the legacy, whatever we choose to call it. One very important guest has joined us in the panel, Srimati Usha Thakur. You might recall how she's a grassroots worker. She works with disadvantaged communities, with women and trafficked women and children. And you would all recall Nithari. So she's the woman who exposed Nithari. So we would go to Usha also to seek her views on women and the condition, how the culture and gender. संस्कृति और स्त्रियों का आपस में क्या संबंध है और किस तरह से संस्कृति कभी कभी आड़े आती है स्त्रियों के उनको दबा के मर्यादा में कहा जाता है जैसे कि मर्यादा में रहना सीखो मर्यादा में ही रहना है तो किस तरह से वो एक चार दीवारी बन जाती है उसके लिए एंड नीलम सक्सेना चंद्रा जी ओवर टू यू फॉर योर व्यूज ऑन जेंडर एंड कल्चर
डॉक्टर वाज बोर्न आई वांटेड टू टेल अ स्टोरी in which there are girls who are the protagonists. And I look back in world history, I look back in Indian history, I couldn't find anyone. Women at the most have been king makers, but they were never at the helm of affairs. So when I started to write, I wanted women protagonists, girl protagonists in my stories. So I found it is certainly culture related. Our culture doesn't approve of women as the person who can save someone or who has something to say. So I started with that. Most of my protagonists are girls or women. I write for children, I write for elders, and in both the places I try to fit in women protagonists, or if the main protagonist is a male, I try to carry along a woman protagonist from whose angle that man is really able to say. So certainly culture and gender are related. It is only now that we get to see women protagonists, that we get to see women achievers. There were not so many achievers in the past. They had to struggle for everything, for voting rights, for working, for everything there has been a struggle. We are lucky to be born in this age where we have so many women achievers, so many people, beautiful people are sitting here who have done something with their life, and I'm really proud of it. Thank you.
संस्कृति और महिलाओं का आपस में एक दूसरे से संबंध है जैसे नदी प्रकृति धरती और ये भारत देश ये सभी नारी का प्रतीक है लेकिन उसी नारी को जिसे संस्कृति का आरंभ होता है नदियों के साथ में संस्कृति का आरंभ होता है सारी संस्कृतियां नदियों के इर्द गिर्द रहती हैं आज नदियां दूषित हैं प्रकृति का शोषण हो रहा है और नारी भी शोषित है जो अपने आप निकल गई जो भी महिला वो निकल गई आगे बढ़ गई शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में हर एक क्षेत्र में निकल गई लेकिन जो पीछे रह गई आज भी बहुत सी महिलाओं को जिनको मैं देखती हूँ कि वो बहुत पीछे हैं शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में ज्ञान के क्षेत्र में अपने अधिकारों के क्षेत्र में तो जिस दिन भी जिस तरह हम नदियों की सफाई की बात करते हैं प्रकृति की बात करते हैं उसी प्रकार घर घर जाके जिस दिन हम नारी की बात करेंगे कि ये तुम्हारा अधिकार है शिक्षा तुम्हारा अधिकार है तुम्हारा भी अधिकार है कुछ स्पेस लेने का स्वतंत्रता का ना कि एक घर के इर्द गिर्द आप घूमिए नारी बहुत पहले से ही भामा थी जो योद्धा थी लोपा मुद्रा थी विदुषी थी गार्गी विदुषी थी उस जमाने में भी और उस जमाने में भी राजा लोग हरम में महिलाओं को रखते थे आज भी वही स्थितियां चली आ रही हैं जिस दिन ये स्थितियां साफ हो जाएंगी महिलाएं आगे बढ़ेंगी उसी प्रकार देश भी बढ़ेगा प्रकृति बढ़ेगी क्योंकि नारी में बहुत क्षमता है वो चाहे तो 24 घंटे घर का काम करके भी बाहर का करके देश को सुधार सकती है लोगों को सुधार सकती है आसपास के वातावरण को सुधार सकती है इसलिए हम सब यदि कटिबद्ध हों कि अपने आसपास के वातावरण नीचे की ओर देखते हुए आगे बढ़ें और उस नीचे के लोगों को ऊपर उठाएं समेटें अपने दामन में उनको सुख समृद्धि दें तो देश स्वयं ही आगे बढ़ेगा आपने कश्मीर की एक गायिका का नाम सुना होगा जिसको उसके पति ने निकाल दिया था और वो खेत में फसल काटते हुए गाती थी अचानक ही एक व्यक्ति उसका गाना सुनता रहा और एक दिन उसने उसको विवाह का कहा विवाह के लिए और वो कोई नहीं और नहीं राजा था कश्मीर का और उसने उसके उस संगीत को इतना बढ़ाया कि आज कश्मीर की घाटियों में उसका संगीत गूंजता है नारी को आप आगे बढ़ने छोड़ दीजिए देखिए कि देश नारी और ये पूरी प्रकृति कितनी सुधर जाएगी कोई कमी नहीं रहेगी हमारे देश में इसलिए मैं कहती हूँ कि अभी चाहे हम मुट्ठी भर चंद नारी हैं पुरुष हैं हम सब मिलकर यदि ये अभियान चलाएं नारी लड़की और यह देश यह प्रकृति तो अवश्य ही सफल हो जाएंगे धन्यवाद
पद्म विभूषण सोलन मानसिंह जी
नमस्कार और there is a huge overreaching arch. At one end, one can quote from great thinkers and poets, or from traditional wisdom. जो कहते हैं कि नारी नरक का द्वार सुना होगा. She is the she takes you to the door of narak. Narak ko kya kahenge angrezi mein? I didn't want to say this. Anyway, uska ek alag cheez hai. And at the other end, the Sanskrit thing which is oft quoted, yatra naristu pujyante ramante tatra devataha. Where woman is worshipped, respected, cherished, loved, that is where gods are pleased. I was talking to someone today, a very knowledgeable person, and the four ends, the four reasons, or the four ashrams, the four, what shall I say, the divisions of work in life: dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Dharma not as religion, but dharma as your karma, what you should be doing in life, what is your responsibility, given mission. And the woman and man are equally poised, are equally challenged to do that. Artha, paisa kamana, iske liye aapne pehle hi kaha ki hunting, food gatherer, but zyadatar abhi artha bhi dono ka barabar hai. Women are working in various fields, right from agriculture, labor, at various stages in various fields. Har ek kshetra mein mahila kaam kar rahi hai, right from political to religious gurus to whatever, whatever. Then kama, that is the sexual field of activity in life, very, very important, by which life cycles are carried forward, societies are formed. And that is where the woman has the upper hand, because she's the one who can control man's unbridled passion, man's unbridled sexuality. And moksha is equally the adhikar of anyone, woman or man. Wonderful. I come to this third one, particularly kama. We are talking generally because such a discussion, panel discussion for one and a half hours cannot veer into many different fields. It will become very large broad. Main ye puchna chahti hu ki why are we not asking questions of films, television, press, and media? Is there any possibility that they have not been responsible to their roles? Would you agree?
Yes.
Because as talking of unbridled sexuality, the crimes committed, or maybe it's because of the media now, we get to know every day so many rapes and murders and molestations and acid throwing and tortures, unbridled violence, mindless sexuality. Are filmmakers aware of that? They are. Then why are they not making films, beautiful films, which can carry this message? They have enough money. The host called TRP on the television, for the television, was not there earlier. And because of TRP, this host, this phantom, we get to see mindless soap operas. Aajkal Nagin, Dakin, Bhutni, all these are, yes? My students tell me, my musicians tell me, I flick the things, I surf the, what's going on here? So again, we are perpetrating the same kind of ideas that Nari Narak Ki Khan, and whatever ills there are in the society, the woman is to blame. It's like saying, ke aap sar dhakiye, aapka baal hame hairan karta hai. आपके बाल देख के हमारे मन में कुछ हलचलें हो जाती हैं, बाल ढकिए. तो मैंने एक जगह मुल्ला जी से कहा, आप अपनी दाढ़ी ढकिए. माफ कीजिए. तो मैं ये जानती हूँ, आई रियली थिंक दैट व्हाई डोंट वी नो द नेम्स ऑफ एवरी मदर हूज great sons have made big names. Kitne mahapurushon ki mataon ke naam hame aaj maloom hai. क्यों नहीं मालूम है, क्यों कोई उनकी बात नहीं करता है, क्यों ऐसी पत्नियों के नाम नहीं लेते लोग. I'll give you a small story example. It's real actually, it's history. Sant Tukaram of Maharashtra, Vithoba, the great temple in Pandharpur. It's a very strange image of Vishnu, two-armed, not four, and standing like this, arms again on the waist, and that there is no Radha, there is no Lakshmi, but Krishna's wife Rukmini, Rukmai, she's called. She's also standing like that. It's a very peculiar idol. Story is ke Tukaram to bhajan kirtan karne mein mashghool, darshan do, O Vithala. Yahan pe in the hut, in the little cottage, I'll take 2 minutes, both of them, Vithal and Rukmini, came to give darshan. They appeared. The wife, Tukaram's wife, who was cooking, she threw a wheat, bit yani eat in Marathi. I'm cooking, I'm busy, I have to feed my father-in-law and mother-in-law who are old. I'll finish this, then I'll do whatever upachara is for you. Both are standing waiting for Tukaram's wife to first feed her in-laws and then do the upacharas to them. This has been, yes. This has been put, this is in the history of the great saints of Maharashtra, where Eknath, Tukaram, all these, Namdev, Gyaneshwar. So my point is that as Gandhiji said, I would not have become a Mahatma but for Kasturba, his wife, okay? And what have we done with Kasturba? We have 1 kg, kilogram mark, half a kilometer, 1 kilometer, you know where. Anywhere else have you heard of Kasturba in this entire big nation, our country? No. Kasturba ashram is another matter. That's not, country's not honoring her. That was settled, my grandfather was a trustee, in fact, when it was semi to when pitted and all. But where are we? So I absolutely agree that Sarojini Naidu, Kamla Devi Chattopadhyay, Ramabai Ranade, Iravati Karve, in every corner there have been great fighters, warriors, queens. There was Razia Begum and Chand Devi and Kumar Pal's Dhruva Swamini Devi and so many. But our history today, I studied history in Gujarati, okay, I'm a Gujarati. Gujarati medium school in Bombay. So I think I was fortunate to read a different history from what is taught today as history. And I think we know about it. Main sirf ye kehna chahungi ki culture and gender, they are intrinsically interwoven. Both genders need to come together in harmony. I don't believe we should look at things now anymore vis-a-vis. Instead of this kind of a struggle and conflict, you know, there are institutions and big organizations for conflict resolution, political. I think we need a gender conflict resolution initiative in a very big way. And instead of uksawing people, you know, then what? Yes, it is so. You've been talking about then what? So then what? So many people are working in this, like they're all working in our own way. And I take now culture to the field of culture, as I, you know, Shobhnaji is here, I'm here. Writers, poets, dancers, musicians, instrumentalists, sculptors, painters, there are great messages in these fields of culture. So I think we need to put so many things together again and go from there. The last bon mot, the good word, Mayahi Jetavyam Sarvam. Aham Jeyo Na Genachit. Everything is to be won by me, this says the female, the feminine. Mayahi Sarvam Jetavyam. Aham Jeyo Na Genachit. I am not to be won over by anyone.
How many? Oh wow, many of you. How many of you remember that, you know, when Draupadi was asking for certain features in her husband, what were the features she asked for? All right, which ones? No, for the, no, for the little. Yeah, no, go ahead. So just the five features that she asked for.
She wanted dharm rakhne wala
batai. Right.
Dusra wo balshali ho.
Right. Have you ever guys wondered that why Draupadi, when she said ye de do, Bhagwan ne kaha ki ek aadmi mein itna kuch hona zara mushkil hai, aapko paanch milenge. Have you ever wondered why, guys? Ever thought about it?
It has a different story. It's a Lord Shiva, because we say Lord Shiva is so simple, he cannot, you know, conceive the thing like Vishnu.
Yeah.
So five times he asked, she said five times yes.
Oh,
so that's the result she got five husbands. Not that he got not able to compile the thing.
Yeah.
Had it been by Vishnu, he might have compiled it. But it's the Lord Shiva, he was not able to compile.
But imagine now, you know, if a guy had asked for all these five qualities in a woman.
दूसरा मिसकंसेप्शन ये है कि तुलसीदास की रामायण जब उनका खत्म होती है उसके बाद लव कुश की स्टोरी नहीं है, ये ऐड किया गया है सीता के साथ ही कि राम ने उसको बाहर निकाल दिया। तुलसीदास की रामायण के बाद जहां वो खत्म हो जाती है उसके बाद कोई चैप्टर ही नहीं, तो हमें वी हैव टू मॉडिफाई आवर कल्चर। So historical culture also.
तुलसीदास जी ने रामचरितमानस लिखी है।
Okay.
रामायण और के बहुत सारे versions हैं south में और इंडिया में।
So my question again, ladies and gentlemen, my question again, if a man had to ask for these five qualities, look at your panelists out here, look at the ladies out here again, you know, each one of you, absolutely.
They do ask all the time,
and they get it all in one. Yeah? So, what does it tell you about men, you know?
What does it tell you about women?
Well, I'll come to that part in a minute, though. I've never understood what women want, but that's sure. So, let me invite over now Ms. Bakshi again, back again. The purpose of She Speaks, ladies and gentlemen, out here is that...
Sonal, Sonal, he had wanted to say something to what you were saying.
Oh, sure, sorry.
I'm interested. I thought you had raised your hand like this.
The same thing, that all the qualities are there in the woman anyway.
In one moment. Yeah.
So the man is very lucky to have one. But then man is not satisfied because of the rubber jaisa hota na, butterfly.
So the purpose, ladies and gentlemen, for this She Speaks is also that we share some social issues. So Ms. Bakshi is going to share with us a case study, a real case study. For the purposes of little secrets, we will not be able to share the name of this person, but we're going to be sharing out a case study, which is a real one. We're going to be throwing up this case study to each one of you, including the panel. What we're requesting here today is, we all know what the problems are. We all probably also understand what the root causes of these problems where are the line. What we do look from esteemed panels out here and all of you knowledgeable people out here is, that can we get some solutions out here so that these can be presented at a better forum, that we can take it forward by saying that here are a few thoughts, here are a few things that we can be doing together as society, and we can take it forward. So request, you know, once the case study is done, that if you could, you know, when we will organize this, that if you could come up with more and more solutions and tell us that try this, look at this, think about this. And that's what we all look for from all panelists and all of you out here. Thank you so much.
With this, we move on to one very important segment of this seminar, a case study. We look around ourselves, we find there is a lot of suffering and pain in the lives of women. So much so that sometimes they are not safe inside their own dwellings. Buddha said, pain is universal and inevitable. But what we make of that pain is a choice that we make. Do we let the pain seize us, or do we seize the pain and turn it into an opportunity? There is a message I often read on a wall written across my terrace. Whenever I happen to go to my terrace, there's a graffiti, you know, across the wall. The graffiti says, if life gives you lemons, make mojitos. So this is an inspiring message. I would like to share with you a case study which has kept me awake for past several nights. Less than a month ago, a woman came to me. I would not like to share her identity and place of nativity because the moment I name the place she hails from, immediately parochial politics and the judgmental side of ours would come to the forefront, alleging, oh, that state, that political party, obviously women are not safe in that state. But I would like to ask one question to you all. Where are they safe? Metros, medium-sized cities, towns, roads, vehicles, or their own homes? This woman, 30-something, who came to me, probably, I think, mid-30s, had been married at the age of 19 with a man who was 48 years old. Two of his previous wives had already died. She was married because he agreed to take her without dowry, and her parents were not in a position, to afford dowry. The man lacked character in every possible sense of the word. He womanized openly in front of her and died within 3 years of marriage, leaving behind two children, a boy and a girl. And on this female fell the responsibility of not only feeding her own self, but also her two small children. Parents agreed to keep the children only if she would contribute a major portion of her widow pension towards household expenses. She picked up a teaching job in a remote hinterland for her subsistence, as she was just a high school pass out, and gave away her monthly pension to her parents towards the boarding, lodging, and schooling of her two children. A few years passed peacefully, but suddenly a school time friend came into her life who was doing a doctorate in IIT Kanpur. He showed great sympathy and love towards her, and they both quietly married in a temple against the girl's parents' wishes. The marriage had to be kept clandestine for various reasons, because the female felt that if she makes it public, she would lose on her widow pension, and if she loses on her widow pension, and she would also lose the wherewithal to raise her children. And man wanted to keep it clandestine for the obvious reasons that he did not have the courage to accept a widow with two children in marriage. Few more years passed by, and she realized the visits of her husband, who had by now relocated to a regional engineering college as a professor, were diminishing. She decided to visit him herself, and to her horror, she found that not only had he married again, but he, with his another wife, had a two-year-old child also. As if their destiny was not unkind enough to her, major crisis was still awaiting to unfold as she found herself 5.5 months pregnant. What is she supposed to do in this predicament? if she fights judicial battle with her husband for her rights, she would lose her widow pension, without which she cannot raise her 2 children and an unborn child. If she doesn't fight this battle, then she loses the battle of dignity and self-esteem to her own self. She came to me in a state of depression and desperation and not knowing what should be her next step. Her true story made me speechless and as depressed as she had come to me. I have no answers. Do you have any? In this situation, what would be your advice to her? I would like to ask my esteemed panelists and each one of you, and at least some answers I see from you all.
She based her second part of her life not on truth. It was based on a very shaky premise. And she should have. So the fear of losing a pension is something, I mean, that to my mind, that was not the correct premise for basing the second part of her life. And also then to accept, if so she was not honest enough to lose the first part and then not honest enough to her own self and her children, because she was not getting the dignity of her wife also from the second part. So I think she put herself in that predicament. And so who does she go to? Because her basic premise for the problem that she's in was based on an incorrect decision. I mean it was based on
But Shobhnaji, I would like to ask a simple question. A mother with 2 children, would she have too many choices if her parents are not taking it? She has no other support, she's not educated enough, she's just done her 12, she's only 22 years old, maybe by this time this happened, maybe 29 years, 28 years. How many choices do women have in such situations? How many options?
I do not know what about the parents' situation, economic situation. Perhaps they were equally in a strained circumstances.
Yes, they must have been.
So obviously, it's very difficult to give you a solution because the parents' situation could have been very, very uneconomically strained. So that's it.
Yes. Anybody? Yes, I'm only looking for answers to give her answers. Yes, sure. Mike?
Yeah, just I would like to say something here, please. There are 2 aspects to your question.
Any volunteers who can take the mics to the raise hands?
There are 2 aspects to the question, ma'am. One, you said is how many choices does a woman have? So either if she's adopted the children, then there's a different case scenario to it. Or if the children are from a man, then there are legal connotations attached to it, and where she can approach the court, ask for the alumni or the man to take care of it. If the children are adopted,
alumni cannot be there. She lost her husband. Her husband died.
See, they wanted, why they married secretly? If a husband is marrying a lady, he must be knowing that he has a children. Then if he is IIT pass out, he must be earning well. Then why he is not taking the responsibility?
I asked her the same question and she said that he refused to publicly acknowledge a marriage with a widow and a mother of 2.
Then it means she is knowing that she is getting cheating at the very first hand. B, she is getting something as a pension of her ex-husband. She is not capable to raise the children on that money, or she is not enough confident to earn more. I mean, people earn so many ways by just tailoring, by doing so many household work.
She's a teacher, and
she is herself is morally weak. I mean, so irony. I mean, okay, I had a total sympathy with the women, but there's something right and wrong.
We very fact that we are discussing making the focus of our discussion this particular time is perhaps showing our collective social bias against this very gender. Why is she the focus of this relationship was objectionable? We all agree that it was differently objectionable, but why is she the target? Why are we not discussing even the least? And when she goes to the man to reconcile and to ask her damages or whatever, he is cool and safe enough. We are not, the society is not yet prepared to make him feel guilty as much as this woman is sitting in class.
Exactly.
Perhaps that focus must be shifted to that man. He is perhaps even more guilty because she was perhaps vulnerable. He was not.
I think both are equally guilty.
Can I give a solution? We all agree that the relationship was based on the premise of lies that she has spoken with her husband, second husband. Okay. Somewhere she has to make a start for her own life. पहली गलती हो गई, गलती से 19 साल की उम्र थी, 48 साल की उम्र से शादी हो गई, whatever said and done. दूसरी गलती हो गई, but then the husband is also at fault. The simple thing for her right now is get her DNA test done. She can always approach a सरकारी lawyer who will hardly charge any money, and there are a lot of courts available, and she can file a case on him because even for the man. This is an illegal marriage. अगर उसने शादी से पहले ये शादी की थी या अपनी original शादी के बाद ये शादी की थी, any which way it is an illegal marriage for him as well. And she can always pull him in the law of court and file a case on him. And I'm sure if she does that, there will be some people who will support her. And she can do all this at the minimum cost possible, in which I do not think so. A lot of economic expenses will also be incurred. Unless and until she really goes in for a higher level. Sarkari law and Sarkari court available hain, and she can go there.
Nahi, Anand ji, aap kuch kehna cha rahi thi?
I might sound a little cruel, but to me the practical situation demands that she aborts that child.
Five and a half months. Doctors refused.
So we can 2 months to get it.
Okay. All right. But then she has to make a new start.
Yes.
And not really, because if you're talking about the moral courage and moral character and all that, wo ek apni jagah hai, ek jo mayusi ho jati hai zindagi
mein, reality apni jagah hai.
और हम लोग यहाँ एयर कंडीशन हॉल में बैठ के गुलमोहर में बात कर रहे हैं, बट द एक्चुअल सिचुएशन ऑन ग्राउंड इज ऑलवेज वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट, वेरी हार्ड ब्रेकिंग. सो आई थिंक शी डिजर्व्स ऑल द सिंपथी, एंड इफ फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट कैन बी गार्नर्ड फॉर हर एज अ काइंड ऑफ अ लिटिल कैपिटल विद व्हिच शी कैन ब्रिंग आउट द चाइल्ड, आई मीन गिव बर्थ टू द चाइल्ड एंड देन गेट ऑन फ्रॉम देयर. But then she'd have to be very brave, and she needs support to carry on with her life.
Maybe pick up a baby which will help her to live in a dignified way.
I would like to say that there are many cases where women are cheated, and women are also doing this kind of work.
लेकिन हम नोएडा में हमारी पूरी टीम है जिसमें काउंसलर है वकील हैं जो रोज ही आए दिन ये केसेस करते हैं और वहाँ पर एक आश्रम भी है जो एक ग्रिजेला है विदेश की महिला है जो ग्रेटर नोएडा में चलाती है कभी आप चल के देखें तो एक रिसोर्ट जैसा लगेगा तो हम ऐसी महिलाओं को उनकी लड़कियों को वहाँ
नहीं उषा जी उस तरह की जो मदद उन्हें दी जा सकती थी जैसे पुलिस से बात करना और वहाँ की जो कानूनी संस्थाएं जो इस तरह की महिलाओं की मदद करती हैं वो उस तक पहुँचा दी गई है लेकिन किसी की मानसिकता किसी की जो साइकोलॉजिकल जो डिप्रेशन है जो टर्मोइल है जो डेली का जो स्ट्रगल है और लोगों से क्लैंडेस्टाइन उसने जो ये रिलेशनशिप बनाई उसके बाद अब नाउ शी इज गोइंग टू हैव अनदर चाइल्ड विद दैट मैन हु इज ऑलरेडी मैरिड तो इसके इतने सारे लेयर्स और पहलू हैं कि इसका समाधान इतना सीधा नहीं है कि वो कुछ एक स्किल ले ले और अपना रोजगार बढ़ा ले या किसी अनाथ आश्रम में या कई महिला आश्रम में जाके रहे या बच्चे को
वो महिला आश्रम ऐसा आश्रम नहीं है वो ग्रिजेला है She was a film star, वो आज चला रही है नोएडा
में
रिसोर्ट की तरह बहुत बढ़िया मैंने बहुत महिलाओं को देखा उनका जीवन परिवर्तित हो गया मानसिक स्थिति अच्छी हो गई और वो बहुत कुछ काम करने लगी उनकी लड़कियां भी वहाँ रह सकती हैं और पढ़ सकती हैं तो ये लड़के को अंजना के उसमें रख देंगे अंजना भी पढ़ाएगी लड़की को वहाँ पढ़ा देंगे और तब तक उनका केस फाइट करके अधिकार उस व्यक्ति से जरूर लेंगे लड़ झगड़ के
पर उषा जी मैं फिर भी कहना चाहूंगी ये बहुत अच्छा है कि आप इस महिला के लिए सुझाव दे रही हैं और आगे आ रही हैं पर मैं ये बात एक मॉडल केस स्टडी की तरह उठाना चाह रही थी कि इस देश में बहुत बहुत सारी ऐसी महिलाएं हैं जो ये सिर्फ एक इस महिला की बात नहीं है पर इस देश में बहुत ऐसी महिलाएं हैं जो इस तरह के क्राइसिस से अपनी डेली लाइफ में डील करती हैं और उन्हें बिल्कुल ये समाधान नहीं मालूम होते ना वो पेरेंट्स के पास जा सकती हैं सोसाइटी उन्हें ह्यूमिलिएट करती है और उन्हें खुद ही नहीं पता होता कि मेरा नेक्स्ट स्टेप क्या होना चाहिए
ऐसी महिलाएं उभर के आई हैं
अपनी बेटियों का कॉन्फिडेंस पूरी तरह डेवलप नहीं किया है और ये गलती समाज की है समाज हमारा आईना है हम जो आज तक करते आ रहे हैं वही फेस कर रहे हैं तो हमें बदलना होगा पुरुषों को ऐसा बनाना होगा कि वो स्त्रियों की इज्जत कर सके जब तक समाज नहीं बदलेगा ये प्रॉब्लम हम फेस करते रहेंगे हमारी बहुत ही दोहरी मानसिकता है ये कहते कुछ है करते कुछ है मेरी मदर 24 साल में अकेले बनी थी 1952 में मैंने देखा है उस जमाने में भी कितना फाइट करना पड़ता था एक नारी को और बहुत बड़े बड़े घरों में एमपीज थी लेडीज उनके घरों में अगर लड़कियां होती थी पोतियां तो वो दुख मनाती थी तो हम जब तक नहीं बदलेंगे तो ये और डीएनए टेस्ट करवाइए उसका और लिविंग रिलेशनशिप में अगर बच्चा होता है तो वो लीगल होता है अगर बाप का फादरहुड अगर आ रहा है तो उसको एक्सेप्ट करना पड़ेगा और पैसा उसको देना पड़ेगा और यही बेस्ट सॉल्यूशन है
राखी जी विमेन फ्यूचर सर्विस की डायरेक्टर प्लीज आप इधर आ जाइए एंड आज मैं एक शी स्पीक्स में एक इम्पोर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट भी करना चाह रही थी कि शी स्पीक्स की हम एक कोर काउंसिल बनाने जा रहे हैं एंड आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट टू नेम्स टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द शी स्पीक्स कोर काउंसिल राखी बख्शी एंड कोर एम्बेसडर मंजू सेठ
Yeah, sure. Whatever we have said, we have to work on self-esteem of a woman. Ab usko Mrs. Banke rehna chhodna chahiye. Whatever name is, she is her. Aur hostels hai, usko maa-baap ke boodhe ho rahe honge. I'm talking about, let her take them to the hostel. So many NGOs are running. So, us bachchon ko bhi apne, bachchon ko bhi apne se dur nahi rakhe, kisi tarah unko hostel mein daale. But we have to work on our own self-esteem. और बड़ा इजी है कहना कि उसने गलती नादानी कर दी वी कैन जज हर बट हमने छोटी छोटी कितनी गलतियां की है और कोई यू नो हो जाती है गलतियां लेट्स नॉट जज हर बिकॉज वी डोंट नो हर परिस्थिति और उसकी सिचुएशन वी रियली डोंट नो एज सोशल वर्कर्स वी ओनली गेट टू हियर सच स्टोरीज एवरी सेकंड डे
व्हाई इज वुमन सो अमेनेबल टू इमोशनल ब्लैकमेल
I have only one point. It is not only women who face
it's not women who are vulnerable or fragile. Even men are equally vulnerable. It's the woman who has to pay the price, and she gets exposed. Men have these now and then, but it's only the woman who has to suffer for it. So we have to really teach. You know, the education has to start at home, where the parents have to convince them. They have to teach their children, their sons, that both men and women are equal, and boys are equally responsible for every situation.
Can I just get this? So I would like to add some points. It's not about Pratyusha, it's not about Kandil, it's not about Arushi. We people are actually, you know, objectifying women. For example, Pratyusha, after Pratyusha died, we in media spoke shit about her. We spoke real wrong words about her. We actually objectified her child, which was, she was pregnant, right? So even women, if I was seeing Facebook, and there were a lot of bad comments about Pratyusha. They were writing about Pratyusha, which is wrong. About Arushi, there were wrong things about Arushi. Objectified her Arushi's body badly when she was died, suicide. I mean, a lot of cases are coming up. Kandil Baroch, Pakistani actress, what she did, she was doing her job. She was a model, she was dancing. Her brother killed her just because of the honor. I mean, I have just one point. Why are we so interested in someone's life? If one person is doing something, she is doing for herself. We should not be interested in someone's life. I am not considering the case right now. I just want to put a point. Whenever you see such a case happening on Facebook or Twitter, please do not write demoralized words. Because these ladies have gone through way too much and then they died. I am not saying that suicide is good. Suicide is not good, very bad. But at the same time, if we are writing something bad when the person is dead, no more, this is bad. This is a personal request to everyone. Please do not write bad words to people who are dying, who are no more, who are not with us.
I just like to. Am I sure? I've got the mic then. In the middle.
Yeah. I'll take 1 minute.
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah. Regarding this abortion, today only the Supreme Court has given a new decision. From 20 weeks, it has been extended to 24 weeks. 6 months. Within 6 months, it can be done. Just for your information.
It's not just the Supreme Court. It is also the health of the woman and what the doctors say. Each case is a different case.
So that's fine. She raised the point. So you said 5 months. I said 6 months. Fine.
So I just like to come back.
Yeah.
I just like to say that it's not just women who are poor who are in difficult situations. I would say people who belong to high society
totally. Also
because totally. Of honor go through
yes.
a lot of
yes.
rubbish.
Yes.
At the end of the day, and I'll speak out of personal experience, we all make mistakes in our lives. We are all vulnerable. And nobody should sit on judgment because we are all human at the end of the day. But the only thing that can save the situation is to take the bull by the horns. Be honest about your mistakes, be creative, develop your skills, move on. Don't think about the men who've been wrong with you. Just develop yourself. And if help is available, like Ushaji said and others are saying, take that help. Don't worry about what's going to happen tomorrow. Try it out. You've tried out two wrong marriages. You can try out somebody helping you.
Absolutely.
Just be honest.
Absolutely.
Because half of the fear and half of the problems we face today is because we say, what will people say? Forget about what then people say. That's the only solution.
I have got a solution. Now, that woman has to try from all the angles, from the medical, from the legal, from the counseling, from the depression, all these things have to be mixed together. And the legal remedy, one of the ladies were there. So legal remedy will be the last resort, which we have to consider in this case. First, she should go to that ashram, take the counseling, what is right under the circumstances. It is the specific, you have correctly said that All the women are different, different cases. Thousands of cases are there coming up in India and Europe or Pakistan or say all over the world. But it is a specific case study. We have to tell this case study with a specific solution.
Thank you. Shobha ji, kuch kehna chahengi special mein?
नहीं मैं तो यही कहना चाहूंगी सबकी बातें सुन रही हूँ लेकिन अल्टीमेट सॉल्यूशन इज दिस दैट शी हैज टू फाइट बैक सॉल्यूशन
शी केम टू लाइक
शी हैज टू फाइट बैक
दैट शी इज यस वांट्स टू फाइट बैक
बिल्कुल इसके अलावा कोई सॉल्यूशन नहीं है और एज फार एज
शी वांट्स टू सेट हर ओन एग्जांपल एंड वांट्स टू बी अ रोल मॉडल सो दैट द अदर वुमेन डू नॉट गो थ्रू व्हाट शी इज गॉन
थ्रू हैव टोल्ड अबाउट हर दैट फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगनिंग शी इज सफरिंग अ लॉट लेकिन एवरी टाइम एक सॉल्यूशन अपने आप में ढूंढा जैसे कि विडो हुई तो विडो के बाद उसने अपना टीचिंग में गई तो इट शोज कि कहीं ना कहीं उसकी स्ट्रेंथ है केवल हमारी जरूरत इसी बात को है कि उसकी स्ट्रेंथ को हम उसकी इमोशनल सपोर्ट को हम बनाएं और यू पॉइंटेड आउट वेरी राइटली दैट वी हैव टू वर्क इन अ वेरी इंटीग्रेटेड मैनर वी कांट गिव हर वन सॉल्यूशन दैट या शी हैज टू गो टू द कोर्ट नो दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल वी हैव टू गिव हर integrated manner emotional support we have to give medical support we have to give and nowadays there are so many NGOs so many people those who are helping such type of women and we should as far as an NGO person I should say ki isme judgmental hone wali baat nahi hai lekin main Sunal Mansingh ji se bhi sehmat hu ki hum log ko kahin na kahin ye bhi to sochna padega ki yes we are a woman But it doesn't mean that we all the time we are vulnerable. कहीं ना कहीं हमें अपनी गलतियों से भी तो सीखना पड़ेगा ये थोड़ी है कि हम ये कह के छोड़ देंगे कि हमारे circumstances ऐसे हैं और सब ऐसे हैं अगर हम equality की बात करते हैं अगर हम इसकी बात करते हैं तो अगर पुरुष गलती करता है तो उसकी भी गलती का solution होना चाहिए उसको भी गलती से सीखना चाहिए In the same manner, woman has to learn. From the very beginning, if she has been in so much trauma, she has to learn. कहीं ना कहीं उसको लर्न करना चाहिए ये मैं आज के लिए उसके लिए नहीं कह रही आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ द गर्ल द वुमन एज अ होल ये हमें सीखना होगा आज हम जब अभी ये जो टॉपिक है नेचर की बात हो रही है कल्चर की बात हो रही है तो यहाँ पे भी मेरा ये कहना है कि जेंडर एज यू आर सेइंग जेंडर तो जेंडर इज ओनली वन पार्ट ऑफ इट कल्चर इज समथिंग वेरी बिग कल्चर मीन्स व्हाट डू हाउ डू यू वियर हाउ डू यू टॉक हाउ डू यू ईट इट्स एवरीथिंग इज कल्चर और कल्चर का इट्स अ वेरी स्मॉल पार्ट हाँ इट इज यू नो दे आर बोथ आर को रिलेटेड समवेयर लेकिन अगर हम जेंडर कैसे कर रहा है जेंडर उसमें हमारे उसकी इमेंसिपेशन वीमेन की या उसकी एम्पावरमेंट हमारे कल्चर को रिच बनाती है लेकिन इफ वो इट इज मेरा कहने का मतलब यह है कि इट इज अगेन अ वेरी स्मॉल पार्ट कल्चर अगर रिच है तो सारी चीजें अपने आप में ठीक होती हैं इसलिए कहीं ना कहीं हमें सोचना होगा कि What is our culture? और culture के लिए खाली women को ही दोष देना या gender पे ही बात करनी वो मुझे लगता है कि बहुत कम हम solution की बात कर पाएंगे क्योंकि culture includes how society is moving. What is society? How the people are living? How is the relationship? तो ये बहुत सारी चीजें और मुझे लगता है ये बहुत ज़्यादा है ये जो विषय है it is not so easy also. बहुत ये सबसे गंभीर विषय है ये बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड विषय है हाँ नहीं वेरी गुड वो तो पहले में नहीं मैं एक मिनट अब आपने मुझे बोलने का मौका दिया तो मैं एक बात और कहना चाहूंगी यहाँ पे
जी
कि आज के समय के अंदर हम लोग एयर कंडीशन में जो बात करते हैं और बैठ के जो बात करते हैं सच में हम रियलिटी में जो बाहर हो रहा है उसका 5% भी नहीं बात करते हैं नहीं समझ भी नहीं पाते हैं इवन समझ भी नहीं पाते हैं ये जो हमारा है जो हम इमोशनल ब्लैकमेल होते हैं क्यों ब्लैकमेल होते हैं बचपन से हमको एक ब्यूटी के लिए कॉन्शियस होना अपने श्रृंगार के लिए कॉन्शियस होना कहीं ना कहीं हर चीज में ये सिखाया जाना कि हम कमतर हैं तो ये जो चीज है ये हमें अपने कल्चर से कहीं ना कहीं से हटानी पड़ेगी कल्चर को रिच करना पड़ेगा विमेन को एज ए व्यूमेन वो उस पे अपने पे विश्वास होना चाहिए उसको अपने पे विश्वास होने का सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है उसको अपने ऊपर भरोसा करना ये सिखाना बहुत बहुत जरूरी है आज भी मतलब बहुत छोटी छोटी चीजों पे हम वुमेन की स्ट्रेंथ और उसकी पोजीशंस नापने लगते हैं।
थैंक यू सो मच जी, वी हैव टाइम
लिमिटेशन, सॉरी।
थैंक यू सो मच। एंड विद द स्कूल ऑफ एजुकेशन एट अंबेडकर यूनिवर्सिटी, इट्स बीन अ प्लेजर हियरिंग एवरीवन ऑन द पैनल। आई जस्ट वांट टू साइनपोस्ट टू थिंग्स। One, that culture and gender are so intricately connected, as Samantha pointed out, but gender itself is a construct. It is not a given. We're conflating gender and sex when we're talking about men and women. We're forgetting that India is one of the only countries that has transgenders as a category of a gender as well. So just reiterating that gender is a construct. It's a cultural construct. It's a social construction. So when we reiterate stereotypes like ladki ko shame kyunki wo उसने गलत काम किया है ऐसे करके, वी आर रीट्रीटिंग दैट द ओनर्स ऑफ द लाइज ऑन द वुमन व्हिच आवर सोसाइटी हैज कंस्ट्रक्टेड। सो लेट्स मूव अवे फ्रॉम दैट, स्पेशली इन अ फोरम लाइक दिस, राइट? लेट्स नॉट रीट्रीट दिस स्टीरियोटाइप्स इन सच अ स्पेस। इन टर्म्स ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस, यू मेंशन दिस इज अ केस स्टडी, राइट? सो वी आर ऑल अवेयर दैट देयर आर सेवरल वुमेन इन आवर कंट्री, बोथ फ्रॉम अंडरप्रिविलेज्ड बैकग्राउंड्स, who've been marginalized because of caste, class, education, and lots of several factors, right? We haven't addressed caste at all. Maybe Usha ma'am has momentarily. And of course, and it's pervasive, of course, even in middle class and high income backgrounds as well. So let's recognize that this is one case that again is about a woman in a difficult circumstance, right? And it is connected because of an act that a man has conducted. Now again, I want to stop here and say that let's not label all men as bad. Let's not characterize men as this, and hence, you know, Pandav the, kyunki sare, you know, all men were not able to fulfill. There are many men in this world who may characterize may characterize all those five qualities into one man, but maybe we don't find many. Just talk about. So let's not bash men, because part of the issue.
Sorry. I'm sure we are not looking for such a man.
We're self-sufficient, that's why. What I'd like to just add and sort of bring it together in some way.
To complement what you are saying, this seminar is addressed to men, but I think I'm extremely fortunate that I see a lot of men in this seminar.
She should leave, you know, whether she should publicly announce she's married to another man, she will lose her widow pension. So she definitely just needs legal counsel, which is available. There are lots of philanthropists who are
working on this.
I know of you
legal counseling
who are things, so I can give some names as well.
Yeah,
if you need.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Yeah. I would like. Raki, I think, wants to say something.
Hello, good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Namrata Sari.
I think that we are coming back to, she speaks, and we are saying why she needs to speak. There is a compulsion to speak, actually, and that's why we are gathered here, because there has been a silence for many years, and now there is this compulsion to really break out of that silence and say that here, you know, I need to speak out. I mean, there is so much that a woman is holding back for years and generations. And that's why now, you know, whether through her dance, whether through her social work, whether through, let's say, and she talked about media and that those voices of expression, I think really needs to come out. And she speaks actually is reflective of that a woman has to really speak up. So we are coming back to that. I think many of you, in fact, when we talked about the case study, also talked about these solutions where she needs to come out. And she needs to make the right choices. She needs to express herself. And that's why should we not start, ma'am, when saying that when we are saying that she has to speak in all scenarios, this compulsion to speak out, to express, you talk about all forms of mediums of television, films, and other forms of expression. Don't you think there is time she needs to speak out?
If you notice that on most of the television discussion panels, prime time news, etc., most of the times you hardly find women, especially where political and such news are concerned. Kahin kahin, if the tribal talaq ki baat hai, then all women panel, maybe with one or two maulvi. But otherwise, where are the women? And I've often pointed this out to people one knows. हाँ 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 नहीं आप ठीक कह रही हैं बुलाना चाहिए फिर कहीं वो दो तीन आपके जैसे उषा जी जैसे को बुला लेते हैं कभी कभार
नहीं नहीं मुझे नहीं बुलाते आपसे
पूछ रही हैं कि स्पेशली द विजुअल मीडिया इज हेवीली फाइंस्ड एंड वेरी जेंडर कॉन्शियस आई डोंट नो व्हाई अब आप फिल्म की बात Let's come to the films also because I think they have a huge, huge constituency. It's unmatched now, unparalleled, right?
Yeah.
Whether it's Mollywood, Tollywood, Hollywood, Bollywood, whatever. Not Bollywood, not Hollywood. So there also women need to speak out. The modern actresses are nice. They are much better than the earlier ones. At least they are not dumb. But there has to be a lot more dialogue and debate and discourses. And the third thing I said, the press, the written press, the magazines. In beauty parlors and dentists' clinics, they are fine, but what do you find there? Femina jaisa jo hai, savvy society. Kya padhte hain aap? How to become more beautiful, how to...
In all the magazines, in all the movies, everywhere. Yeah, the problem is also there.
First of all, when it comes to films, I don't really fully agree with Sonalji because I think films is the softest target. Anything that goes wrong, more films are corrupting us. I really think that's giving them far too much
influence.
Yeah, well, the other thing is that I think today the films that we are seeing are far more, conscious of these factors than films that were made earlier in the 60s. I don't think you're going to see a film where some mother-in-law is beating up the daughter-in-law and she's still pressing her mother-in-law's feet and so on. I don't think you'll see that anymore.
Now you at least in movies you see
women who are working, who have jobs, who are outspoken. I don't think you saw, I'm a big film buff and I see old films all the time. And I think that earlier films...
I can give examples like the film...
No, I'm not seeing examples. You may find one film or two films. I'm saying overall you have to see. I don't think anyone can deny that the films we are making today...
Most of the movies are like that, ma'am.
I take songs. Kareena Kapoor, Bihasha, Neeri Jalai,
moral outrage against I don't get it actually. Why are we morally outraging against somebody who's dancing?
So let's look at those spaces. Are there enough spaces now? That's what I think we're trying to say. We are saying we are trying to speak up. Are there enough spaces? Are we finding the right platform?
I just want to add platform per film mein, politics mein, ya kahin aurte bolne lagi. तो वहाँ पर उनका बहिष्कार हो जाएगा महिलाएं भेड़ की तरह सिर झुका के अगर पॉलिटिक्स में हैं, किसी नेता के पीछे घूमे यस मैन बने तो वो ठीक है लेकिन जो बोल्ड महिलाएं उनके लिए प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस करते हैं लोग नेता लोग उनकी प्रसिद्धि आगे ना बढ़ जाए वही हाल फिल्म्स में भी है फिल्म्स में वही महिलाएं सफल हैं जो यस मैन और सिर झुका कर काम करते हैं
There is certainly a need for more space. I would, while this discussion was going on, I was remembering the ad of Ariel. Very simple ad. कि एक नाना अपने नाती के साथ खेल रहे होते हैं, बेटी घर आती है. वो सारे काम एक साथ शुरू कर देती है बेटे से पूछती है होमवर्क हुआ कि नहीं नाश्ता खाया कि नहीं पिताजी को टिकट ला के देती है उधर सब्जी फ्रिज में रखती है ऑफिस का फोन आ जाता है और फिर भी हस्बैंड मस्त चाय पीता है जो कि यही बना के देती है और कहता है मेरी ग्रीन वाली शर्ट धो देना सो एटीट्यूड हैज टू चेंज एंड अनलेस दैट चेंजेस वी कांट चेंज द वर्ल्ड Both. Even I should know that it is my right not to be always giving tea to my husband. I can also expect my husband to get me tea if I have time.
I'm not going to share my personal experiences here. They're waiting for my autobiography. But I was just saying one thing, that I am known as a very honest and forthright person. Though I've been told by friends, you know, you intimidate men. And that's what they've heard from their male friends. I said, it's much better than being inviting.
These so-called stereotypical definitions, as she raised the right point actually. Would you like to take it further and say something? Like she said, whether it's about, you know, being seen as intimidating, seen as what?
I think that among the, you know, women I know, the younger women I know who have worked with, the older women, everybody, I think women have actually, at least talking of middle class urban working women, I can't speak for everybody, I think they have moved light years ahead, and I think the men just haven't caught up. I think they are far more evolved and strong, and they are able to handle their lives, and they have really grown as individuals, and the men are still stuck somewhere in those old ideas.
Men are still groaning.
So I think they have to really play catch up.
You know, so to come back to see and say gender and culture, Vinita was raised with them. So when we talk about gender culture, it's there should be culture of shared responsibilities. You know, so that culture that we really are asking for, come together. Nobody is saying me, you. Let's come together and let's, you know, walk on a path which is more cohesive, more comprehensive, and which works together in harmony.
I would say with
mutual respect. And admiration.
Sometimes
you have to fight for your rights.
We have to.
Sometimes you have to. You can't be sweet about everything.
Very true.
Sometimes you have to say no.
Yes. Totally agree with you. So any final words? As you, I can see that you're not even.
I see a lot of raised hands in the audiences because I know this is a topic which cannot go in one single direction, and it is good that it cannot, and we have no final solutions, no solutions, but many opinions. Okay, yes, actually, and yes, I think I would really like to hear from these two ladies what they have to say.
Actually, I feel that most of the discussions which I attend, the end result, we reach nowhere. That should not be. Mm. So the first point was our case study. Mm. So in this case, the most important is woman's mental health and how she has what woman's mistake, who has done what, but not, that is besides the point now. What was to happen has happened to her. Now I feel as a NGO group or all the ladies, great ladies who are behind all this, who are helping these women, they should, first of all, like somebody said in the audience, that 6 months, yes, I'm a doctor too, for a woman's mental and physical, and she has a life ahead. So if it is possible, she should go ahead with the termination of the pregnancy. You are bringing to a society.
She's already visited AIIMS and Moolchand and has been refused.
No, I don't think so. Yes. You people can influence the doctors as well. That should be the first solution. So that you are bringing a very complex personality into this world, and when that child grows up, child will also grow up with a lot of complexes.
My first reaction was exactly as you.
That is my one suggestion. If it is possible, she should go ahead with that. And second thing is that women are made differently and men are different. Women think differently, they are emotional. Most of the times they may be fooled, or men think differently, you know. They are more objectified, the women. But then you know, like women cannot.
I think we have to wrap up.
Yeah, in that race of, you know, equality.
And we have to inaugurate this project.
Yeah, just one second. Women cannot.
You know, you've spoken about speaking up. You've spoken about speaking up,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes,
you've spoken
about, yes.
I think, yeah,
inherent has a point to make.
A woman will make a cup of tea for the husband. The husband does so many other things. So we should take it in that stride, actually. So that we are happy together.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Dr. Vandita. And I would like to invite my esteemed panel to inaugurate this brochure before we leave. She is a broadcaster at Rajya Sabha TV and director at Women Teacher Service and deals with issues related to women empowerment. And Ms. Mantu Seth is a former ambassador and is extremely passionate about women's issues and empowerment. And today we invite Ms. Rakhi Bakshi and Ms. Mantu Seth to formally be a council member for She Speaks Advisory Board. I would like to invite Dr. Amrin Khatwa on stage, and he would be the chair for Amrotsar 2017. And I would like to share the dates of Amrotsar 2017 with you, 16th and 17th of December, IGNCA. Development project.
come on stage.
So let's get the camera.
Jai Shri Krishna. Make photograph.
हाँ बिल्कुल आइए
sir. Everybody wanted to say something.
Thank you. I think I have all the results. Again, one more. Ma'am, one more. Thank you.
I'm a Gujarati from Bombay.
I've lived in Bombay many years.
But I was there much before.
Not much. At some point. मुझे क्रॉप कर देना अगर आप
इनकी वेबसाइट पर दें अरे मुझे प्रिपेयर कर लेता हूँ
आशी
थैंक यू सो मच विनीता जी फॉर इनवाइटिंग टुडे आई थिंक इट वाज अ वंडरफुल सेशन वंडरफुल पैनलिस्ट ऑन द मून ऑल द फीमेल्स हियर we discussed a lot of issues, yes, once you start a discussion on a female, a lot of issues which are intricate and they are so complex, it is difficult to arrive at a solution for any one issue in a small gathering of 100-200 people and maybe within an hour or two. However, I think more important is that women are getting, they are evolving with time, with education, with their professional lives and also a little bit with the Cosmo culture. So it's not only important that we all as females, as women, we extend a supporting hand to other females, which is happening, all the educated females, they are supporting other females hand in hand and they are ready to move forward, call it entrepreneurs, call it even the girls who are filling up the petrol pumps, and of course the women from art, from academia, from different sectors as CEOs. So She Speaks is giving such a beautiful platform. You are empowering women who really need the support from people like us who are little educated, who need to be little aware about their rights. It is really good to be with them, to counsel them, to support them. A lot of different issues and how to lead a life which is independent, be by yourself, and that being a woman, you do not always need to depend on a male figure in your life, be your father, be your brother, be your husband, or be your son. So I think She Speaks is doing a wonderful job. Thank you so much for inviting me on this forum, and we are all with you to take She Speaks forward. Thank you.